and then tell me why we're here.
Fair enough.
Okay.
Right?
We're ready.
That's easy, isn't it?
Yeah, right.
Okay, let's go.
Gets harder. Yeah, so hi, I'm Paul from Sonar Works. I'm the product manager for our TrueFi application, which we'll be showing you today, as well as sort of show you a small glimpse into the future of what we consider the future of audio and audio personalization.
Okay.
That pretty much covers it.
Talk. Okay.
That pretty much covers it.
All right. Right. So, well, great. Well, you guys have a great show. And, okay. All right. Why are we here?
So basically, we want a demo to what we call the journey to your ultimate sound experience.
Okay. I want you to look at me when you're talking.
Okay.
I know,
gotcha.
It's hard. I know it's difficult, but.
Not sure where. All right. So, yeah. So, the journey to getting the ultimate sound experience, what that means. There's several steps that we're going to take to get you there.
Mm-hmm.
We already have some covered in our mobile application, and some we're still working on, and we can give you a sneak peek on how that's going. For a bit of more background, should we go to the presentation or? Yeah.
You just relax and do whatever whatever you think is natural. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine. So yes, the essence is your ultimate sound experience. So. The main point is that ultimate sound experience on any sound device, and there's several ways we can do that. So currently, in all the trade shows and most companies, they keep releasing new hardware, and the hardware keeps getting better and better. The capabilities are better, but they still all sound different, and their quality is limited to the hardware. So. That's sort of the general problem we initially are addressing. So here, as an example, you have a graph showing how different the headphones sound. So you can see in the bass, they're all over the place. On the high end, even more all over the place. There's very inconsistent colorations that they give to the sound. So with our technology, Sonarworks Studio Reference, we bring them to the same kind of consistent neutral sound. The sound we chose for this target is based on our experience in the studio world. So over 30,000 studios are using our software to calibrate their speakers and their studios. So this is a very neutral sound that studio engineers work with. Ideally, listening with the Sonarworks Studio Reference, you are hearing what the artist and the engineer heard in the studio when they were mixing the song. So using this, this is a bit more of what I just mentioned. We have a lot of Grammy awarded engineers as endorsers.
Just real quick.
Sure.
Where does Sonar Works come from? What is your base business? I mean, how did you get into developing an application for a cell phone, for a mobile app?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, where did you come from, and how did you get here?
So we started working with in the studio landscape. So basically, fixing the problems studio engineers have when they're trying to do mix downs for their tracks. It's very important that they have a consistent sound coming from their speakers. Otherwise, they'll be mixing the bass off or the high. Basically, just having a consistent neutral sound is the baseline that they need to accurately mix the track. So from our experience in that sphere, what we noticed is we can start bringing this to headphones and sort of bridging the gap from the source of the music to the end listener. This way we get as perfect as possible translation from the studio sound to the listener, as well as having the same sound across all devices, speakers, headphones, cars, which means some things we're working on now to do with personalization. once you personalize the sound to your preference, you can have that exact same sound across headphones, speakers, or cars. So ideally, throughout your day, wherever you're listening to music, once you know how you like to listen to music, you can have that everywhere.
So now the consumer can have studio sound in their headphones, in their speakers at home, in their earbuds.
Exactly.
And it can be driven by their mobile app.
Yeah, so that's all mobile-based. We also have the desktop app. That's all packed into the kind of the mobile application that we have right now.
Okay.
Google Play and
okay, now tell us a bit about this mobile app.
Yeah, we can get to the demo, I think, now. So we can show you the demo of how the sound from our mobile application mm-hmm. translates to our sort of
new speakers
to Matisse's studio. So
yeah, exactly.
This is Matisse. He's a sound engineer, and he'll guide you in this part.
Of course. Okay. So my name is Matt. It's Matiss.
Okay.
And as Paul briefly mentioned, I am an actual audio engineer. I do work at a studio, and if you ever need mixing some metal tracks, I'm your guy. So what we have set up here is a our own take of what we could improvise on the spot in a just random hotel room. So we brought the pair of the studio speakers, and we brought a pair of very cheap consumer headphones. So, and our current technology offers you the kind of opportunity to experience the sound from this very nice pair of studio speakers, and have that sound directly translated over to this very cheap pair of headphones.
Mm-hmm.
And for this demo, we'll actually be using my elaborate setup over here in the background. But essentially, what we're going to do is we are going to run two separate instances of Spotify.
Mm-hmm.
And that will Paulus and I will have to try and synchronize, because we have to actually play press those two play buttons at the same time.
Okay,
or
it.
With a calculated delay, so they actually start at the same time. So for this demo, we'll actually need somebody over here in the driver's seat.
Do we have volunteers?
Do
perfect.
I did it last year.
Volunteer?
Right.
Last year I did it.
Yeah, right. You did.
So what we're going to do is we are going to play a rather rock-ish track called Killing in the Name of by Rage Against the Machine. And our basic reasoning behind that is it has so much information for anybody to work with. So any inconsistencies and any flaws in any acoustic technology will be very easily spotted by using such dense track. And how this is going to essentially go down. So we're going to start by listening to the speakers, getting the feel how they sound, how they feel like, and then you would put the headphones on, and I'll mute the speaker so you hear only the headphones. And when you're listening to headphones, after a brief moment, you just take them off, and I'll unmute the speaker so you can actually compare it directly side by side.
Okay.
Right? And in the app, there's also a nifty little button that will turn the calibration off after you've compared the calibrated sound between these two devices. All right?
Okay.
Any questions?
No.
You're nervous.
I mean, I'm the best guinea pig ever.
Perfect.
Because this is supposed to be easy for any customer.
Well, I mean, you know, a typical customer wouldn't have like this very huge elaborate
right.
setup with different routing. It's like you literally would just open the app, press play,
and go for it.
Enjoy
and
your music.
All right, let's go.
Right,
let's
so, Paulus,
yep.
So the countdown is.
I'm on three, you're on four. Huh?
Yeah, basically. It's more like two and a half, and I'm on four.
All right.
Well, we'll see. We'll compare. All right? You going to go for the countdown?
All right. One, two, three, four.
Right. And I'll just quickly flip back to the speakers. Now it's going to be a bit noisy, so just heads up for that. So how we're on the sync.
That's a bit ahead. Pause and play again.
Should be close enough. All right, gotcha. So, let's start by listening to the speakers, and then when you're ready, just put the headphones on.
To kill me. I don't know what... I mean, it sounds the same to me.
That's the goal. So, not to kill you, but for them to sound the same. So,
okay.
So when if you put the headphones back on and just flip this little button.
I remember that from
yes.
out here.
All right.
Basically, disabling the calibration is how the headphones sound.
Out of the box.
Yes,
cheap.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
Huge difference.
Yes.
Huge difference, absolutely.
And we're not doing anything bad to the headphones per se, as,
right.
you know, the first initial kind of reaction might have been is like, oh, you're deliberately destroying the headphones. Not really. You could just do this exactly the same thing on every device out there.
It's amazing.
Right.
So, okay, you're not spending $300 for high-end headphones now. You're
no.
spending $30.
Yeah, I mean, you could definitely spend $300 or $3,000,
but
yeah. it's really up to you. But
but you could spend $30.
You can spend $30 and
no.
be perfectly happy with that choice. As long
okay.
as they're comfortable and you like how they look.
Right.
Whatever floats.
Okay. this app, how do you get it and how much does it cost?
I'll bring that over to Paulus.
So right now we're pricing it at zero. So you can just go to Google Play or the App Store, download it, and give it a run. So yeah, right now it's iOS and Android. If you're interested in trying out the desktop version, then there's a free trial for that for Windows and Mac as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So if you do the mobile app, it is free to use.
Yeah.
For
it's,
how long?
So right now we're planning to roll out some new features and with that some subscription options around quarter two. So right now we're considering it an early access type of release.
Okay.
But it's all free. All the features are there.
That's good. That's real good. That's what people like to hear. All right, anything else that you'd like to add? Both of you get together over here. And
we do have actually like a second part of the whole
oh,
thing.
Oh, you got another part.
Oh, yeah, we have more goodies for you. Don't
oh,
worry.
Come on.
Don't worry.
Yeah.
Okay.
Come
no
on,
rushes.
Come on.
Show me what you have. Show me what you're working with.
So, yeah, I'll bring Paul back in the picture as well because he's
okay.
got some explaining to do.
Okay.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. That's bad.
Some explaining.
Okay.
So,
I'm good.
That's my bad.
It's always in the way.
So, this was sort of a demo of where we're at right now. With the mobile application, with the desktop application, where we've come from, getting the studio reference on your mobile device, meaning everywhere. Everyone, wherever you are, you can
mm-hmm.
listen to the sound that way. So, looking at the future is a very important part is that we all obviously hear sound differently, not just in terms of hearing, but obviously in personal preference.
Mm-hmm.
So building on that, this is what we're going to be calling the ultimate sound.